Hey there, we're at video 7 in the Painter step-by-step setup. Now, what you're looking at is the welcome window in Painter 2022, because I'm going to bring stuff that I had in Painter 22 into Painter 2023. Now, one of the ways you can do this is by importing a workspace. But it's getting less and less advantageous to import a workspace. There's so much change that happens in the background that the older workspaces will come in, but you'll find you'll have these little glitches here and there that don't work as well. So it's best to build your workspace again. And so I'm going to bring in parts of this stuff. So, for instance, let's close this, and I'm going to open up, we'll go to Windows, Palette Drawers, and we'll open up Papers and Flow Maps. Okay, so here are my Papers and Flow Maps, and if I go to the bottom here, I can manage my library. So if I click on that, I can say export a flow map library, and that's what I'd want to do. Or I could be on Papers and click on that same little button down here, and I could export a paper library. Now, when it says import legacy paper library, that's old libraries that have a different kind of extension. If you can't get something to import, try using the import legacy paper library. All right, so I'm going to export paper library, and I'm going to export not paper textures, because that's not one of my custom ones. I'm going to come down here and decide what I want to bring forward. That's a lot of stuff. I'm going to start with Tim's traditional watercolors. Let me go up the page. Yeah, I think I'm going to start with Tim's traditional watercolor papers. I really love those. And I'll say, okay, and now I have to decide where to send it to. And I think I want to send it directly to my Painter step-by-step and put it in resources under papers and then just save it. All right, so what I'm going to be doing is creating a resource page that has all of the things that I'm going to import into Painter. So I just go back down here and I export Painter library again, and let's just see what I want to export. All right, so I have Corel Geometrics. That is a paper library that I created for Painter, and I can't give that to you. You'll have to buy that, but it is available. Okay, so now I want to do the same thing again, export paper library, and we're just going to go back up to the top here, and we'll Dramatic Papers is also a set of papers that I created for Corel. Cannot give those to you, but you can buy them. Okay, export, and we come up here, favorite watercolors 2, and we'll say okay. Now that's actually, that was a, that's a paper setup or library that was created when I brought in a box, but and actually, I'm not going to send it over, because I'll be doing a different one. I'm going to hold on Karen's Japanese grains for a minute. I want the paper drips, though, and I'll say OK. And then I'm going to go to I'm going to go to Simplicity, which is another one that I created for Corel. I don't think it's named Simplicity, though. I'm not sure. We'll just move that one over here. And then we're going to go to, let's see, Suminagashi. I definitely want those. Save. And then we'll go here. Export. And we're going to come down to thick paint drips. And we're going to do my traditional style papers. And we're going to, no, that's not what I wanted to do. Yep. Export paper library. Paper textures is one that comes with everything, so I don't know. Whoa, new woven. And I don't remember these right now. There may be some I bought. Or it could be some I made and I just don't remember. but I don't remember that one, so. And I'm not sure I remember that one. I believe those imaginary papers, those may be, oh my God, my mind is losing me. Don. They're probably Don's. I don't know why I couldn't remember his name. All right, so we've transferred those in or over. So let's minimize Painter 2022. And here's Painter 2023. I'm just going to get rid of the open window. And I'm going to come up to Window, Palette Drawers, and Papers and Flow Maps. So I'll start here, import paper library, and we go to our Painter step-by-step, resources, papers, and I can just simply grab this and say open. Then I will go back to the same place, grab the next one and say open. And I hope these are working. Yeah, they're there. Scared me for a minute. It didn't look like they were actually working. Import paper library. We go to imaginative and say okay. Import paper library. We go to paper drips, okay. Import paper library, simplicity, okay. Import paper library, Suminagashi, open, okay. Import paper library, thick paint drips, okay. And import paper library, Tim's traditional watercolors. Import. I did that one. Traditional, my traditional style papers. And and import paper library. Woven new paper library. I swear I don't remember that one. It may be the name for my simplicity or one of those. I'm just not sure right now. I'm sorry. But there, we've added a whole bunch of papers. Now, that is the way I would add my media to the new workspace. I would just simply go in and import and export the actual objects. Okay, so I'm going to save my layout. Don't forget to do this before you close Painter. And then I'm going to close. Let's see. If I go to, I just saved the layout. So I've saved it with this open. And you don't want to have anything open like that. So I'm going to close that and go back to the layout and save layout again. We'll call it skips 2023. Okay, yes. And I am now going to close Painter, and I will stop the video and see you in the next one shortly. Bye-bye.